Hello and welcome to this LS Central video. My name is Áslaug Guðjónsdóttir and I'm a product specialist in LS Central. In this video, we're going to look at some base data all retailers need, like stores and terminals. Here we are in the LS Central back office. Let's look at the store list, where we create and maintain all the stores the retailer needs. It is easy to add in more stores when needed. We are in the store card. Each and every store has its ID, name, and we can put in the address, postcode, phone number. LS Central is based on unified commerce strategy, meaning that all the different functionalities that the retail needs are in one system. And very importantly, data is created and maintained in one place. The retailer's e-commerce or customer facing apps may need to show the user where the store is located on map. So here we have the values for the latitude and longitude of the store. For each and every store, we can as well register the retail calendar or the opening hours of the store, where we have on Mondays, this store is open from 8 to 8, on Tuesdays from 8 to 6, and etc. This then can be used again by the retailer's e-commerce, customer-facing loyalty apps, or some functionality that is using this. For each and every store, we can import the store's logo, and we can as well import the street view of the store. That again can be used by e-commerce or the customer loyalty apps. Each and every store has some tender types. And if we open the cash tender types and look at some of the settings, we can see that each and one has a number and a description. Here we have an option may be used. During COVID times, some stores and cafes have stopped allowing cash to be used in their stores. So then it's easy to go here, disable this functionality, and then the POSs belonging to the store cannot use cash payment. When COVID times are over, they enable this option again. Door opens is another option that decides when a sale is finished, does the drawer open or not. That's very normal for cash, but perhaps not for other tender types like card payment, where you don't want the drawer to open too much for security reasons. Then you would have that tender type with disabled drawer opens. And you have a rift on the drawer that everybody puts the receipts through. Another section here, amount, field like over tender amount. That is very normal to do for cash payments, but not for card payments. And you can even define what is the amount you can over tender. Here you have decided the rounding, none nearest up or down. You decide rounding two, posting up section. After each and every day or shift, all the store sales need to be posted into general ledger. And here we define the ledger account that the cash payments go to. And if there is difference between calculated amount and counted amount, then we have another setting here to which difference general ledger account this is all posted. Each and every store has one or more terminals. So from the store card, we define the terminals. And they can be one or many, and it's easy to maintain and create new ones. Let's look at a few of the settings. So each and every terminal has a description and it belongs to a fixed store. To give an example of settings, exit after each transaction. So when the store sale is over, does the terminal automatically log off? Does the cashier need to log in for next transaction or not? This is normal to have disabled for grocery stores, but if you are going to use our system in specialty stores, like a jewelry store, then it can be practical to exit after each transaction when the salesperson goes directly into the store again to service next customer. Another setting is auto lock off after minutes that you identify in this field here. Let's now look at the terminal. We can log on to the terminal, and I'm going to log on to this one here. And what information are we looking at? In the status line, we have different information. So here we can see that the receipt number. And part of the receipt number is the terminal number. And when we know the terminal number, we know the store number. This part of the receipt number is a running number going one upwards for each sale. More information about LS Central can be found in the LS Central online help. Thank you.